1962 Chevy Nova Caltags are unique in many ways from 1963 and later, especially the accessory codes, which don't always match later first-gen cars. Many people have asked questions about decoding 1962 tags, and I have a little secret that might help those first-year Nova owners out. Hi Nova fans, my name is Scott, and it's a beautiful Black Friday here in southeastern PA. I hope you all had a nice Thanksgiving with your family and friends. I did, but the last place I want to be today is a mall or a crowded store. I'd much rather be here making this video for you. In 1965, Ralph Nader published a book titled Unsafe at Any Speed, and in it he called the Corvair a one-car accident. Now, because of that, some people think that book killed the Corvair, and Chevy created the Nova to replace it. Well, that's not entirely true. Nader gets a lot of heat from Corvair fans, Chevy fans, even car enthusiasts in general. And while he and his book did begin the government establishing safety and emissions regulations that diminished performance, he also made cars and driving much safer and cleaner for us today. Now, I'm no Nader supporter, but his book only mentioned the Corvair in one chapter and only used it as an example for the lack of safety in modern cars. So, did Nader's book kill the Corvair? Not exactly. While it didn't help, it had more to do with all the lawsuits that were already filed against Chevrolet that started back as early as 1961, 4 years before Nader's book was even published. It was also the introduction of the more conventional Chevy 2 Nova in late 1961 that pulled sales away from the Corvair. So then, did Chevy create the Chevy 2 to replace the Corvair? Well, since the Chevy 2 started in the 1962 model year and the Corvair lasted through the 1969 model year, I'd hardly consider an 8-year overlap as a replacement. No, the Corvair was an economy car for those who wanted a more European-style car like the VW Beetle or the 356 Porsche, while the Chevy 2 was an economy car for those that wanted a more traditional American-style car. So by now you may be wondering, why am I talking about Corvairs instead of Novas? Well, there are a few reasons. One, I really like the Corvair, especially the 1965 through 69 second generation. Two, I feel the Corvair and Chevy 2 Nova are kind of a companion cars. Both are designed to be economical, but having different styles for a different buyer. And three, Corvairs and Chevy 2 Novas were built at the same time at the same plants, especially in 1962 when the Chevy 2 Nova had some strange coating on the Caltag. As I've said before, I get a lot of questions emailed to me about Novas, and decoding 62 Caltags is a common theme. Recently, I received an Instagram DM from an @Lisa_62Nova. Now Lisa owns a 62 Nova convertible built at the Oakland plant. Her question reads like this. I have a question about my 62 and I was wondering if you could help answer it. I was told that the Caltags from the Oakland plant were sometimes hard to decipher. I have everything figured out except for the options. I have three sets of letters on my Caltag, B, P, and E. And only E, tinted glass all, shows up under the options that were available for the 62. What would those other options on my car be? Now, I've had a hard time answering questions like this in the past because there was very little on the internet or in decode books about 1962 Nova accessory codes. But what I've discovered is there's some help from the Corvair world. Because Corvairs and Novas were built at Willow Run in Oakland plants, we can assume that Oakland used the same codes on Novas that they did for Corvairs. Now, I was looking up Corvair codes, and the accessory code B at the Oakland plant was for a Powerglide transmission, and the accessory code P at the Oakland plant was for a padded dash. So if you have a 1962 Nova with strange codes on your Caltags, and you haven't been able to figure out what they mean, send me an email or expand your own search to include Corvairs. Now, not all codes will apply, but for the most part, what works for a Corvair will be the same for a Nova. Okay, that's all for now. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please click the like button and be sure to subscribe if you haven't done so already. Leave comments down below or email me at scott@novaresource.org if you have any ideas for future videos or you just have questions that you'd like me to answer. Also, you can follow me on Instagram, at Nova Resource. I post pics of Nova every day, and if you'd like your Nova featured, please send me a high-quality picture or two and a short description to scott@novaresource.org. Take care and happy motoring.